Morning, Rabotai. Yesterday we were speaking about the halachot of tefillin, more specifically about the fact that a person is not allowed to be mafsik at all between tefillin shel yad and tefillin shel rosh. A person can't interrupt at all, preferably not even with time, but certainly not with speech or with any other action. Now, for that reason, a person is not allowed to talk, we said yesterday. Sometimes it happens that instinctively, habitually, a person hears a kaddish, a kaddisha, and between tefillin shel yad and tefillin shel rosh, and he'll answer. And then he'll realize that he made a mistake. The halacha is, although in general, if a person speaks between tefillin shel yad and tefillin shel rosh, he would have to make, although in general, da'at marana shulchan aruch kedat arifah rambam, that we only make one beracha on the tefillin, lehaniach, for both tefillin shel yad and tefillin shel rosh. However, if a person speaks, he'll have to make al mitzvah tefillin for the tefillin shel rosh. However, that's only with regards to speaking. If a person accidentally, habitually answered amen or kaddish or kedusha between tefillin shel yad and tefillin shel rosh, over there b'di'avad he would not have to make a bracha of al mitzvah tefillin before the tefillin shel rosh. Now, this applies to tefillin shel rashi. Nevertheless, with regards to tefillin shel rabbeinu tam, between tefillin shel yad and tefillin shel rosh, if a person is caught in the middle of dvarim shel kedusha, kaddish, kedusha, yeshem rabba, barechu, whatever it is, the halacha is that he must answer. Nevertheless, it is asur for a person to put himself in a situation whereby he will have to answer any one of these dvarim shel kedusha between tefillin shel yad and tefillin shel rosh, even of that of Rabbeinu Tam. For that reason, a person should be wary when he's putting it on during, you know, if he's putting it on during Chazarat HaShatz, which anyways, we spoke about in the past, is a problem. Guess what? Every so often, by Chazarat HaShatz, you'll have to answer Amen. If you're putting on Tefillin Shel Rabbeinu Tam in the middle of Kaddish, then you know you're going to have to answer Kaddish. So that's a problem. You have to find the time to put on Tefillin Shel Rabbeinu Tam that is not a time when there will be things to answer, because then you'll be faced with this dilemma, and preferably you're not supposed to answer it by Tefillin Shel Rabbeinu Tam as well. Yom.